Hello, Matthew. It's Dr. Dave here once again for you and all your neuropsychotherapy readers out there. And I'm here from Northern California once again to talk about my podcast series, Shrink Wrap Radio, in which I interview movers and shakers from around the broad world of psychology. And I'm here to talk about today's interview, which is Shrink Wrap Radio number 441, in which I interview therapist Molly Young Brown about psychosynthesis, past, present, and future. And psychosynthesis is one of those approaches to psychotherapy that first broke the water here in the US in the early 1970s. That's when we started to hear about it, and it got a lot of attention. And then over time, it seemed to kind of fade out of view. And unfortunately, I think the US is. Things get chewed up and spit out very quickly here. So that, things, an approach can get a lot of media attention, as a number of not innovative approaches did in the 70s. And then people develop a sense of familiarity and feel like, okay, that's old news, and they move on to the next thing. Well, to give you a little preview of what happened to psychosynthesis is it is still alive and well, but not so much in this country as in Europe and elsewhere, maybe even in Australia, where you are. Psychosynthesis was developed by an Italian, Roberto Assagioli, who was a psychiatrist, and Molly Young Brown was one of the people who early on picked up this study here in the US, and she went to study with Assagioli in Italy. Psychosynthesis is not an entirely unique approach, rather, it's one that draws upon many other influences, including Jungian psychology, Rogerian psychology, Gestalt, existential. But it does introduce some very effective techniques, and I think its status today certainly is that as a very integrative approach, it's something that could be easily adapted into other approaches that, say, a therapist is using, so that this interview, I think, could have real relevance to anybody out there who is a psychotherapist currently. And is looking for some new tools to add to their kit bag. Well, I could go on and say more, but I think that's enough, hopefully, to get everyone interested in my interview with Molly Young Brown for Shrink Wrap Radio number 441. And so with that, it's back to you, Matthew.